chef-inspired cavador.
say. You might really does flash before your eyes. There it all was, stretching back to my childhood. Born into a family of master hunters that went back for generations, I was next in line to continue the Clipper name. I landed in wasn't all bad. It was there that I met my lifelong friends. Bentley, he's always been the thinker. And Murray, he's the doer. We stuck together over the years, and our skill, our confidence, and our thieving reputation grew stronger with each heist. We thought that the good times would never end, and that our luck would never run out. Which only made things tougher when the odds finally caught up with us. Then I met this guy, McSweeney, who claimed to have run with my father's crew back in the heyday. They threw jobs all over the world, and amassed quite a collection of priceless items. It was then that McSweeney told me all about the Cooper Vault. It seemed that my father, like all my ancestors, had been hiding their wealth in a secret place for generations, each one adding to the treasure hidden behind a door that, if McSweeney's story is true, only a Cooper can open. Using some well-placed clues provided by McSweeney, we set out for the secret island that held the vault. On arriving, we discovered someone by the name of Dr. M had already set up shop. From the looks of it, he'd been trying to crack the thing for years, growing steadily more frustrated in his failures, and more paranoid as the decades rolled by. He built himself a fortress, with security as tight as Fort Knox. Getting inside the place would take precision, creativity, and moreover, it would take an army of world-class thieves. Finding and bringing together that much talent won't be easy, but to get inside the Cooper Vault and collect my inheritance, I was willing to pay the price. Getting inside a world-class vault would take a team of world-class thieves, a group of specialists, each member contributing their own particular talent. It was clear that we needed Murray back. Missing a lifelong friend, but his good strength helped get us out of more than a few scrapes in the past. When Bentley was injured during the whole clockwork affair, Murray blamed himself, eventually leaving the team. We tried to console him, but going out on his own was something he needed to do. He said he wanted to find his spiritual center. We got word that Murray ended up in the Australian outback, where he studied a mystic art called the Dream Flower from an Aboriginal guru. From all accounts, things went pretty well, and his teacher even sent him on a walkabout to locations all over the globe to complete the training. The latest reports have cited Murray in beautiful Venice, Italy, but what he's doing there is a mystery. I just hope he steers clear of the local mob boss, Octavia. Growing up, this guy used to be a real celebrity in the neighborhood. Everyone loved to hear him sing opera and said he was destined to be the next great tenor.
responsible for the disaster. Unfortunately, we've got no hard evidence linking him to the pollution. I've yet to receive a warrant to search his opera house mansion.
Nice work.
Head
back to Dimitri's cell and free him. If he's true to his word, we'll be talking to Murray in no time.
Let's get back to business. Now, where was I? Hold tight, boys. The power's on the fritz again. It'll calm down in a few minutes.
Better make sure you're under a desk when the lights come back on.
Hello, assorted meatheads and lady. Anyone feel like some exercise?
Over. Grab him, man.
And I'm out.
Thank you.
door's not the safest option.
That wooden hatch appears to be an ideal way to slip in undetected. Head down there and we'll be up in a few minutes.
Thank you. enjoying yourself. That's the important thing.
Aside from a few tense moments, that break-in seemed to go pretty well.
It's not over yet. Hack the system and let's get out of here.
Oh, it'll be a snap. Extracted the details on Octavio's operation from this old dinosaur. What? A delay switch? Sorry, Sly. Guess the dinosaur has teeth. I'll hack as fast as I can. Watch my back. There are sure to be guards on the way.
Isn't that, I don't know, attractive? Hold up, here it comes. That's despicable.
Get a picture before he finishes. This is perfect. And use your binoculars to take photos. Excellent. A few more of these and the cops will bury this guy. Follow him. He might be headed for some more polluting.
Thank you. sources tell me that Octavio has hired the Blue Viper Gondola Gang to take out Carmelita.
The Blue Vipers? Those guys are nasty. We've got to get to them before they get to her.
She's off on her daily patrol. The thugs can't be far behind.
On my way. Just make sure to have one of those police boats hotwired by the time I get there.
There go the Vipers.
I'll shoot. You drive, Sly. This canal is packed with shipping. Make sure to cut a feed from your son. Sorry, Sly. My gun overheated. Yes, I should use short burst.
Another uneventful patrol. This city is beautiful, but a bit quiet in my taste.
I hope you realize that by saving Carmelita, we're only making our operation here more difficult.
Maybe so, but what's the fun in stealing if there's nobody trying to catch you? Besides, she's helped us out in the past.
That, and you've got a thing for it.
And I've got a thing for her. Look, I'll stash this boat. It might be useful for later. You stay out of trouble.
Ability
location for the old bait and switch?
Yeah, the game's following me. Let's move out for cover. They gotta move.
Now to get those mercenary apes involved.
Thank you.
hosting a full-time guard in front of a coffee house.
Since we destroyed his Ferris wheel, he's gone all out of the security. In fact, he's got all his guards checking up on each other. If we're going to get inside and at the blueprints, we can't raise any suspicion.
I'm with you. I'll approach the guard while in disguise and pretend to take the next shift. When the coast is clear, you head inside and swipe the blueprints. With me standing out front, no one will know that something's up.
Your disguise could be assigned as a power. When hailed by guards, make sure to memorize their passwords and save the bag in a timely fashion. Take too long or mess it up, and you'll know you're a phony.
And grab the blueprints. No telling how long until another patrol comes by.
Cafe, Castle.
As I expected.
Tony B's nickname?
Tony B? That cannoli. He's a, what's it called? A egomaniac. I don't know nothing about him. Don't want to know.
Soprano?
Sorry about that.
So, Big Shot, what's my nickname?
Oh, come on. Everyone's heard of Tony the Killer Bee. You're the terror of every player grounder from here to Sicily.
Me funny. Least I'm not on guard duty during Carnival. Who's got the last laugh now, tough guy? Me, that's who.
Too long. If that guy comes back to chat, I'm out of here.
You've got real skill with this art decryption, Bentley. It always takes me like 20 minutes to figure those things out. You're just flying through them.
Safe house. That alarm is attracting all kinds of guards.
Agree. We've got the blueprints to the tar vacuum. Our work here is done.
Excavating all that tar seems like a big operation. You'd think he'd hold off until he had an audience.
Exactly. Now, I've cobbled together a
to those balloons. Unfortunately, I'm a little short on fuses.
Then I'll be quick.
Real slow and use it to fertilize to make tomato plants.
I'm a
between you and me. I hate opera. You there. What's Octavio's house password?
Transmitting password.
Tenor soprano, tenor soprano.
Okay. The boss has been practicing for months for this event. He sings great.
Looking forward to the performance. But once I'm done in the pump room, I'll be headed out to the stage. If it isn't too much trouble, would you help me with this double button security door?
But of course, for a fellow musical lover, it would be a pleasure. On a three. One, two, three. Be quick in there. You won't want to miss out.
Take some more bombs. Still time to catch Octavio's recital?
We're right on schedule. If my calculations are correct, he should be about to perform an aria originally written as a duet. That's when we strike.
Think he'll really let you on stage with him?
Of course! He's a musician! He'll be
Switch, and we'll all try to ditch these cops.
You chasing me for this? Fine, big shot. Took me 6 months to prepare this deal. But what the heck? I got more where this came from.
You guys see that boat go out of control and jump and crash into that thing? Destruction! So cool!
You think that wasn't cool, punk?
Seen someone move that fast. Octavio's old, but he's still got it. Let's take him together.
But I vowed to my guru that I renounce all violence, and the water is still black.
It'll be clear any minute. Trust me. Now, let's take it.
You're right to be scared, Hippo. Your wheelchair friend should have been so smart.
Outside.
Thank you.
and scrape Bentley off the pavement. It was touch and go for a while there, but we managed to sneak out right under Carmelita's nose. Octavio wasn't so lucky. The guy got 30 years behind bars for what he did to this. I guess Italians don't like it when you sink their landmarks. Ironically, he found success as a singer while in jail. After all, most of his old fan base was already in the film. But the big score here was bringing our old pal back into the game. Once he put on those gloves and that mask, he was clear to everyone, most of all him, that the murder had returned. Seemed just like old times. The gang was back in action. But little by little, we learned that Murray's heart just wasn't in it. Without the guru's permission to give up on his dreamtime training, he'd never really feel comfortable returning to the gang. We knew we needed to help him out. Told us story after story about his teacher's amazing abilities. This guru of his was capable of fantastic feats. He used the dream time to blend perfectly into his surroundings and even gain mental control over the weak-minded. If even half the stories were true, then this was a guy I just had to meet. Our gang needed to grow its ranks for a chance to find the Cooper Vault. And this guru, this outback mystic, was looking like the best recruit you could have ever asked for. However, when we finally arrived in the outback, it was a shock to find that things had changed. And the guru was nowhere to be seen. Speaking of it, I'm headed for the hut. Be the guru. I'm a good friend of Murray's. He's come asking to be released from his training. Sure, I'll just bust you out of here and we'll go talk to him. You seriously won't leave without your gear? Yeah, I can see that the miners have really done a number on your land here. As for your walking staff and moonstone, me and my gang have a real talent for stealing back things that were wrongfully taken.
He also insists.
Back to your rightful owner. But these miners are smarter than they look. They booby-trapped the moon stone. It looks like a light-sensitive detonator. If I can get it outside and into the sunlight, it should power down.
Special about this staff.